Sani Patri Sapidi Spiritu Sancti. Amen. In Trevo Alatari Dei. Utica me Deus et discerne causa meam, de gentinum sancta, omine iniquo te lo so erue. Emite lucem tuum et veritatem tuum, ipsa me deus serent and adus serent in montem sanctum tuum et in tabernacula tua. Confitebor tibi in citra deus deus meus, quare tristis es anima mea, quare conturbas me. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. In Trevo Alatari Dei. Adjutorium nostrum in nomine Domini. Confiter Deo omnipotente, Beata Maria, Semper Virgine, Beata Michele Arcangelo, Beata Ioanni Baptiste, Sanctus Apostolos, Petro Apollo, Omnibus Sanctus, et Vos Fratres, Pio Peccavi Nimis, Cogitatione Verbo et Opere. Mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Video praecor Beatum Mariam Semper Virginem, Beatum Michaelum Archangelum, Beatum Ioannem Baptistum, Sanctus Apostolus Petrum et Paulum, Omnes Sanctus et Vos Fratres, orare pro mea Dominum Deo Nostrum. The offer of vestry omnipotence is dimisis peccatis vestris perduca vos ad vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam absolutionem et previsionem peccatorum nostrorum triquat nobis omnipotens et misericordes dominus. Deus tu conversus vivificabis nos. Ossende nobis domine misericordiam tua. Domine exaudi orationem mea. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Dominus illuminatio mea et salus mea, quem timebo. Dominus defensor vitae meae, atque trepidavo. Qui tribulat mei inimici mei, ipsi infirmati sunt et ceci deunt. Si consistant adversum mei castra, non timebit cor meum. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Dominus illuminatio mea, et salus mea, quem timebo. Dominus defensor vitae meae, ab quo trepidavo. Qui tribulant mei inimici mei, ipsi infirmati sunt et ceci deunt. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax omnibus bone voluntatis. Laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratias agimus tibi, propter maniam gloriam tuam. Domine Deus Rex Celestis, Deus Pater Omnipotens, Domine Filii Unigenite Iesu Christe, Domine Deus Agnus Dei Filius Patris, qui tollis peccato mundi miserere nobis, qui tollis peccato mundi suscite deprecationem nostram, qui sedes ad dexterem Patris miserere nobis, coniam tu solus Anctus, tu solus Dominus, tu solus Altissimus, Jesu Christe, cum Sancto Spiritu, in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus. Da nobis quesimus Domine, ut et mundi cortus pacifice nobis tuo ordine dirigator, et ecclesia tua tranquilla devotione lectetur. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat, in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lectio Epistulae Beati Pauli Apostoli ad Romanos. Fratres, existimo quod non sunt condigne passiones vius temporis ad futuram gloriam, per revelabitur in nobis. Nam expectatio creatore revelationem filiorum Dei expecta. Vanitati eum creatura subjecta est non volens, sed propter eum, qui subjecit eam in spe, quia et ipsa creatura liberabitur a servitute corruptionis, in libertatem gloriae filiorum Dei. Scimus enim quod omnis creatura ingenisit et parturit usque ab, non solum altem illa, sed et nos ipsi primitia spiritus aventes, et ipsi intra nos gememus adoptionem filiorum Dei expectantes, redemptionem corporis nostri, in Christo Jesu, Domino nostro. Propitius est o Domine peccatis nostra, ne quando dicant gentes, ubi est Deus eorum, adjuve nos Deus salutaris noster, propter honorem nominis tui Domine libera nos. Alleluia, alleluia, Deus qui sedes super tronum et dignitas equitatem, est o refugium pauperum in tribulatione. Alleluia. Dominus vobiscum. Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Lucam. In illo tempore cum torbe irruerunt in Iesum, ut audiret verbum Dei, et ipse stabat secus stanium Genezaret, et vidit duas naves stantes secus stanium, piscatores autem descenderat, et lavabant rexia. Ascendent autem in una navem, quae erat Simonis, rogavit eum a terra reducere cusidum, et sedens docebat de navicula turbas, ut cessavit autem loqui dixit ad Simonem, duc in autum, et lapsate rexia vestra in captura. Et respondes Simon dixit ili, Preceptor, per totam notum laborantes nihil cepimus, in verbo autem tuo lapsabo rete, et cum hoc fecisset, concluserunt fischium multitudinem copiosa, rupebator autem rete eorum, ad anu erunt socius, qui erant in alia navi, ut venerent, et audiuvarent eus, et venerunt et impleverunt ambas naviculas, ut ita ut pene mergerentur. Quod cum videret Simon Petrus procidit ad genua Iesu dicens, Exia me, qui homo peccator sum, Domine. Stupor enim circumdederat eum, et omnes qui cum illo ceperat, illo erant in captura piscium quam ceperat, similiter altam Iacobum et Ioannem, filius Zebedei, qui erat socii Simonis, et ait ad Simonem Iesus, noli timere, ex hoc iam hominis eris capiens, et subductis ad terra navibus, relictis omnibus secutis sunt eum.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In our passage from St. Luke's Gospel for today, we have the most detailed version of the call of Simon Peter, along with the other, the first disciples. St. Peter is an apostle, certainly, but he's one that at least I find myself that I can relate to often enough, right? He's impetuous, he's believing, right? He's the one that in the midst of that silence in Matthew's gospel, when our Lord says, who do the people say that I am? And they give the opinion poll and he says, but who do you say that I am? Peter's the one that steps forward in faith and says, you are the Christ, you are the Son of the living God. In John's gospel, he's the one that after Jesus gives the bread of life discourse and says, you must eat my body and drink my blood in order to have life in you. When many people begin to leave, you can imagine our Lord feeling a little despondent, I think, and his disciples leaving him. He turns to the 12 and he says, and you, what about you? Peter's the one that responds and says, Lord, where else can we go? You alone have the words of eternal life. Right? He's the one that says, Lord, if it's you, command that I come out and walk on the water to you. But he's also the one that notices the waves lapping at his feet and begins to fear and fall. He's the one who, when the Lord is arrested, says, I don't know the man. Right? We see in Peter a model of all disciples, of ourselves. Men and women who believe, but also who falter, who fail. And so I think it's beautiful that St. Luke gives us this very detailed account of his calling. He's been working all night, right? And the Lord, it's in the morning, there's this crowd that's wanting to listen to him, and, you know, he didn't have a microphone and a sound system as we do here. So what did he do? He saw that they were along the shore of the lake and there were some boats there. And he said, if I put out a little bit from the shore, my voice will sound over the waters and people will be able to hear it instead of I'm standing right on top of it. The Lord was a master of communication. He wanted his word to go out. And so he asks Peter, he sees these guys standing along the shore washing their nets after a night full of work where they caught nothing. So you can imagine their mood, right? They worked hard and they have nothing to show for their labors, but they still have to clean these nets. And then they probably have to wash down the decks of the boat. The Lord says, would you mind if I hopped in your boat, Peter? And we put out a little bit. It's not recorded. This is the most detailed account of the calls, but I can imagine there's a little bit of an eye roll in St. Peter. Or if it was my boat and I had worked all night and I was tired, there would have definitely been an eye roll for me. But he acquiesces. Our Lord hops in, they put out, and he begins to teach the crowd. And then after he teaches them, he says, listen, why don't we go out a little farther? Set out in for deep waters, and then put your net over the right side of the boat. Now, again, St. Luke doesn't tell us this, but there could have been a moment for an eye roll there, right? I'm the professional fisherman, and you're what, an itinerant rabbi? Who are you to know and tell me how to do my job, right? Think about ourselves. In the midst of our everyday life, for things that we know how to do, people come in and say, you know, or if you're doing a crossword puzzle and someone leans over your shoulder and says, five across is... But Peter doesn't roll his eyes, or at least he doesn't tell us. And he does. He sets out for deep waters. And he throws the net over the right side of the boat, as the Lord told him. And the man who had caught nothing that entire night has a catch that is straining the nets, so much so that they're at the point of breaking, that he has to call out across the waters to another ship to come and help out. Imagine this is the ship of Zebedee with his sons James and John. And so these two boats are pulling this huge net full with fish, St. Luke tells us, to the point that both of them are almost being pulled under. They make it to shore, right? And you would think that Peter is exuberant, that he has had this great catch, his business is going to survive. What does he do? He doesn't say, all right, this time tomorrow, you're going to get back in and you're going to tell me where we go and which side of the boat so that I can do this again. No. He says, depart from me. for I am a sinful man. He does these two things. First, even at this early stage in his relationship with Christ, we imagine he might have met him, he might have seen him walking along the shore before. Right, Andrew, his brother, a disciple of John the Baptist, the one who introduced Peter to Jesus, that would have happened before the beginning of John's Gospel in John chapter 1. He recognizes in this man the Lord. And then he acknowledges himself as a sinner. This is common. We find this throughout the entire scriptures. That in the midst of all of these things, when we're at an encounter with the divine, not only are we in awe of his presence, but at the same time, when we are caught up in the glory that's his, we're aware of the lack of glory in ourselves. Right? We can do a compare and contrast and realize that we fall up very short. But the Lord doesn't say, oh, gee, you're right, you are a sinner. Sorry, I gotta leave. I don't want anything to do with you. Neither does he say, oh, that's okay, you're fine, it's not that big of a deal that you sin, don't worry about it. No, the Lord takes that moment to give Simon Peter his vocation. And he says, you, from now on, you will not be a fisherman. You will be fishing men. He gave him his vocation there in that minute. In that moment, he acknowledged him as the Lord, and he recognized the fact that he was a sinner. Was the moment that he received his vocation. Christ doesn't call those who are perfect. Example number one, right here. All we have to do is look down through the history of the church. Right, Judas was called by the Lord, and he abandoned and betrayed him. All the way down through the ages, the Lord has called imperfect men to varying degrees. In the past years, we've seen to greater degrees of that. But that does not stop the Lord choosing imperfect people. It's all that there are on this earth after him and his mother. But he is able to do great things from them. He doesn't call those who are perfect, but he calls those whom it chooses him, whom it pleases him to choose. Right? He calls each and every one of us to follow him, to be his disciple. Yes. We are imperfect, each and every one of us. But he looks at us with our skills, with our boats, with what we have, and he says, I can do something with this. With these hands, with your hands, I can do great things. He chooses and has a call for each and every one of us. St. John Henry Newman said that I might not know what that call is. But in spite of that, the Lord has committed to me and to each of us some definitive purpose that he's not given to anyone else. The Lord has a plan. His plan is that his word, that this communication, that his word might be revealed to all people. We saw that how he set out from the shore so that all people could hear. Well, he no longer physically walks this earth. And so it's our hands, it's our feet, it's our lips that are called to reveal and to share his word. And he's entrusted to each and every one of us some definitive thing that no one else has had it committed to them. And so if we do not respond to this call of the Lord, if we do not step up, then part of the Lord's plan isn't going to be. He chooses us, imperfect as we are, to be his disciples. Of all of us who are called to be his disciples, he calls some, like he called Peter specifically, to be an apostle, to be a shepherd, to be a priest. In our diocese, we have 9 young men studying to be priests. He doesn't mind me calling him out. One of them is here joining. Mass today, Peter. Everyone's spinning around. He's just there in the back. We have 3 other young men who have been accepted for formation for next year. We have a couple more in the pipeline maybe for next year already, for this fall. And then there are some that are thinking about for the following year and years in the future. Imperfect as we are, the Lord is able to do some great thing. Because it wasn't just in any boat, it was in Peter's boat. And even today, we still gather in Peter's boat. The part of the church that you're sitting in is called the nave. It comes from the Latin word for boat. Because if we turn this upside down, it would look like the hull of a boat. That we are in the bark of Peter. That this is where the Lord has us situated, in his ship. And so on this day, I think the Lord is inviting us to pray for Peter, Pope Francis, that he might be a faithful shepherd, to pray for all of the apostles today in the church, all of our bishops, that they might be faithful to the call that they have received, to pray for our priests, those who are continuing this work, to be fishers of men. Pray for your pastor. Selfishly, I'll ask you to pray for him. He needs it. Pray for our seminarians. Thank you. No, it's not an easy task to go through seminary. It's a bit of being in a fishbowl where everyone's looking at you to make sure that you're ready, that you're able to serve, that you're not going to be more of a dud than not. Yes, we're all imperfect, but we don't want to just put anyone in front of the people of God. Pray for those who are discerning, those from our parish who are discerning. Pray for many more, that the Lord's work might continue, because he's entrusted to each and every one of us some definitive purpose. Let us pray that his will be done on earth in our lives as it is his will in heaven. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Patrem Celi et Terre, visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum Iesum Christum, filium Dei unigenitum, et ex Patre natum ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo, lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo vero, genitum non factum, consubstantialem Patri, per quem omnia facta sunt, qui propter nos homines et propter nostram salutem descendit de celis. Et incarnatus est de Spiritus Sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Crucifixus etiam pro nobis supuntio Pilato, passus et sepultus est, et resurrexit tertia die secundum scripturas, et ascendit in caelum, sedet ad dexteram Patris, et iterum venturus est cum gloria judicare vivos et mortuos, cuius regni non erit finis. Et in Spiritum Sanctum Dominum et vivificantem, qui ex Patre filioque procedit, qui cum Patre et Filio simul adorator et conglorificator, qui locutus est per prophetas, et unam, sanctam, catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confiteor unum baptisma in remissionem peccatorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, et vitam venturi saeculi. Amen. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Illumina oculos meos, ne unquam obdorbiam in morte, ne quando dicat inimicus meus, prevalui adversus eum. grate fratres, meam apodestrum sacrificium macis habile quid apodem patrum omnipotentem.
Sucia Domine sacrificium te manibus suis, et aure me gloria nobis sui, et ex tu patrum et nostra patris, ecclesiae sui sacra.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum. Sortum corda. Gratias agamus Domino Deo nostro. Vere dignum et justum es equum et salutare nos tibi semper et ubique gratias agere. Domine Sancti Pater omnipotens excerpti Deus. Ficum unigenito filio tuo et spiritu sancto unus est Deus, unus est Dominus. Non in unius singularitate personae, sed in unius trinitate substantiae. Quod enim de tua gloria revelatite, credimus hoc de filio tuo, hoc de spiritu sancto, sine differentia discretione sentimus, ut in confessione veris empiter neque deitatis, et in personis proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in maestate adoretor et qualitas. Quam laudant angeli atque arcangeli, cherubim quoque ab seraphim qui non cessant clamare quotidie, una voce dicentes, Sanctus, 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 Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Caelia terra gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis. vis quoque peccatoribus. Omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Precepti salutaribus oremus, precepti salutaribus moniti et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere, Pater noster, qui es in celi, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, viat voluntas tua, sicut in celo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi dona nobis pacem. Domine non subdinius. Domine non subdinius. Domine non subdinius. Campeti Domino Hamquic Requiram, ut inhabitem in Domo Domini omnibus diebus vitae me. Dominus obiscum,
et cum spiritus
tuo. Oremus. Quos celesti Domine Donos satiasti, praesa quesimus, ut ad nostris mundemor occultis, et ab ostium liberemor insidiis, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regna, in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritus tuum,
ite missa est.
Deo gratias.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum, initium Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem.
Gloria tibi Domini.
In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat verbum. Hoc erat in principio apud Deum, omnia per ipsum facta sunt, et sine ipso factum est nihil quod factum est. In ipso vita erat, et vita erat lux hominum, et lux in tenebris lucet, et tenebrae eam non comprenderunt. Fuit homum Iesus ad Deo, cui nomen erat Ioannes. Hic venit in testimonium, ut testimonium per iberet illumine, ut omnes crederet per illum. Non erat ille lux, sed ut testimonium per iberet illumine. Erat lux vera, qui illuminat omnem hominem venientem in hunc mundum. In mundo erat, in mundus per ipsum factus est, et mundus eam non coniovi. In propria venit, et sui eam non receprunt. Quod quod autem receprunt eam, dediet eis potestatem filios Dei piedi. Quis qui credunt in nomine eius, qui non ex sanguinibus, neque voluntate parvis, neque voluntate viri, sed ex Deo nati sunt. Te verum caro factum est, et habitavit in nobis, et vidimus gloriam eius, gloriam quasi unigenitia Patre, plenum gratiae veritatis.
Deo gratias.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now
and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. O God, our refuge and our strength, look down with favor upon thy people who cry to thee. Through the intercession of the glorious and immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, of thy blessed apostles Peter and Paul, and of all the saints, do thou mercifully and graciously hear the prayers which we pour forth for the conversion of sinners, for the freedom and exaltation of Holy Mother Church, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke and we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan, and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, most Sacred Heart of Jesus, most Sacred Heart of Jesus, prayer in times of epidemics. Deal not with us, Lord, according to our sins. Help us, O God, our Deliverer. Remember not, O Lord, our sins of old.
Hasten to us with thy compassion, for we have become exceedingly weak.
Saint Sebastian, pray for us.
That we may be worthy of the promises of Christ.
O Lord, hear my prayer.
And let my cry come to thee.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Vouchsafe to hear us, O God, our only salvation. And through the intercession of the glorious and blessed Mary, Mother of God and Ever Virgin, Of thy blessed martyr Sebastian and of all the saints, deliver thy people from the terrors of thy wrath and restore their confidence by the outpouring of thy compassion. Be moved to pity, O Lord, at our earnest entreaties, and heal the illnesses of body and soul, so that experiencing thy forgiveness, we may ever rejoice in thy blessing. We beseech thee, O Lord, grant us a hearing as we devoutly raise our petitions to thee. And graciously turn away the epidemic of plague which afflicts us, so that mortal hearts may recognize that these scourges proceed from thine indignation and cease only when thou art moved to mercy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui tolle peccata mundi. Domine non sub dignus in interest subtectum meam, sed tantum verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine non sub dignus in interest subtectum meam, sed tantum verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine non sub dignus in interest subtectum meam, sed tantum verbo et sanabitur anima mea.